Hey friends, welcome to Living It Country. Today I am so thrilled to be sharing another farmhouse styled home for the Christmas 2020 season. And today I am thrilled to have Shelby and Michelle here from Farmhouse Living on YouTube and Instagram sharing their Christmas 2020 home tour. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started.
Hi, my name is Michelle and I'm with Farmhouse Living. Shelby and I are so excited to share my home with you today. We have a simple Christmas, not too overdone, though I love an overdone Christmas. I wish I could do that, but I don't have the skill and the talent for that. So we have a simple Christmas. We have a woods behind us, and so we use a lot of fresh greenery, and we just bring nature inside, and that's kind of our inspiration. So first, this is my living room, and again, we just pulled from the nature preserve in the back, and through this wooden bowl that I have, filled it with some pine cones and some greenery and use a wreath, and we have a really minimalistic tree with gold and navy, which is kind of the theme this year. We've gone with a lot of gold and a lot of navy. We did all gold on the mantle, and again, we pulled from the nature preserve, and we have our fireplace decked out with just a lot of green. So we bought this house 3 years ago and we redid the home because it was pretty stuck in the 80s. And when we did, I asked my husband if he would weld me this firewood box, which he said would be crazy because it's like 800 pounds worth of plate metal. But he loves me and he did it. And so we just love keeping our firewood here. It's a little empty because we've had some cool days in Texas. Not so much today. I think it's like 70 something. However, you gotta have a fire for Christmas. Hallmark is on the TV because we love to binge watch Hallmark every year. And so this is always what's on in the background. Into my breakfast nook, we have something that we really, really love every year, where we just use this greenery to frame the family room from the breakfast nook, and it's very inviting and cozy, and it doesn't take much to throw that up there. And again, we just use a lot of greenery and bring the outside in. So we have eucalyptus and some branches here. And this year we did something new on the wall. We actually own a little coffee shop, Shelby and I, and we used our old coffee board, which we weren't using anymore, to bring in some,
Whimsy.
Yeah, I love this home because this is a great place to display my nativity every year. In my last home, I didn't really have it as the star of the show, but this old dresser is a great place for my nativity to shine, and so I just love to display it here since we moved in, and it looks great. Again, keeping it fairly minimal in our kitchen, we just have a Christmas tree and we have wreaths. If you've seen that lady put a wreath on it, like that's what we believe in. Put a wreath on it. If it's naked, just put a wreath on it. And so we've put a wreath on the vent hood and just thrown some greenery up there. And I have my gingerbread house. I think we were at a Christmas tour of homes today and she had so many gingerbread houses that's gonna be my new collectible. I want, from now on, everywhere I go, I'm gonna look for gingerbread houses because they're just so sweet, and I think a big display of gingerbread houses is the best. I only have one to start. I wanna show y'all my dog room because no one gets to really enjoy the dog room. It's usually just for my puppers. But at Christmas time, we hang Sadie and Sam's stockings and we get them a little festive in here. It's also my bunny room, and you can see my bunny in the corner over there. Come on, Sam, get in your bed. And Sam has his Christmas sweater on, and Sadie doesn't fit in hers because she's with puppies right now. Next, I'll show y'all probably my favorite room, which is our dining room. And we're just now getting to the point where it's finished. It was pretty bare before, but we're starting to see it come together. I always keep this dough bowl and I change it out seasonally. And again, we just pulled from the backyard and we filled it with greenery, some balls, and we put a wreath on it, the back of the chairs. I love this old piano. It actually belongs to my son and he's getting married this year, and I'm hoping he will leave it with me for a while because it's really neat to have the kids playing music and singing, and the baby loves it. And now it's a great place to display my little houses. So if he does end up taking it, then I'm gonna have to find another vintage piano to put in its place. We have my reindeer and a flock Christmas tree, which you don't have to decorate. Again, simple, because for me, it's just a flock Christmas tree is beautiful just as it is. I really don't do much in the entry. We just put some garland on the stairs. I had some bows last year, but I didn't make it that far this year. So we've just got some greenery, and then again, we have a wreath. And just a simple entryway that leads into our guest room. Most people don't get to see our guest bath. There's not much to it, but I did do a fun little wreath in the round window. So that's my extent of Christmas. Put a wreath on it. Now, this is the pièce de résistance. We redid the guest room and we painted it forest green. It's an evergreen color that really is Christmassy, and so we've really just done this room and it feels like a Hallmark movie to me. It's just so beautiful, and so I hope that when we have company, they'll enjoy this space a lot. We just did another simple tree and we hung bows, and we have just a few ornaments, not very many, and a little cozy sitting nook and some baskets on the wall. We have a new chandelier, which really makes a statement in the room, and we really love it. This color is just everything. We're super excited. Next, I'm gonna take you to a space that we really don't show very much because it's not done at all, but I did hang a few wreaths, so I'm gonna show you my master bedroom. I'd like to paint this room. It's the latte from the 80s still. This is the last room on my list, but it is cozy and warm, and even though it's minimalist, we really, really love it because we have the woods in the back and we have a beautiful place to sit. And anyway, this great tree just makes the whole space warm and fuzzy and cozy. So we hope you enjoyed this home tour. We are so excited that we get to share with y'all, and we hope you have the best holiday season and most Merry Christmas ever.